Yo, the voice of reason. Listen, I'm gonna keep the pressure up for my remaining shows. This is Zoe Williams, the voice of reason, live on KBLA Talk 1580, sitting in for Dr. Jashana Johnson, man. This is the voice of reason. We broadcasting live from Leimert Park, Los Angeles, California. It's even sunny at nighttime. Boy, I'm gonna keep the fire up. I'm gonna keep the pressure on. Let me just say this, man. This show is live. It's broadcasting live from KBLA Talk 1580, but it's also broadcasting live on my YouTube channel. And all the people on my YouTube channel be like, I can't hear the callers. That's because you have to download the KBLA Talk 1580 app. You download the app, you press play, and you'll be able to hear the callers and the wonderful playlist that I have that fits the topic. Now, we've got a couple of things to take care of before we get into the topic. The topic's crazy tonight. But as you know, for the past week and a half, or, you know, since Black History Month started, KBLA has a wonderful giveaway happening. And every day, we announce the winner. Yes, there's a winner every day. Let me show you how to participate. First, let me tell you who today's winner is. Today's winner of the KBLA Black History Month swag bag is Daryl Zett Jackson. Yep, that's how her name is. Daryl Zett. That's what her it sounds and it spells just the way it looks. Daryl Zett. Maybe her mom was Yvette and her dad is Daryl. Daryl Zett, we're giving away a KBLA Black History Month swag bag every day this month. There's so many chances for you to win. Trust me, we still have, 2 weeks left in this month, 2.5 weeks left. So there are many opportunities, plenty of opportunities for you to win. All you have to do is go download or open the KBLA 1580 app and tell us who your favorite historical figure from Black History Month is. Right? Or from Black History. Just tell us who your favorite historical figure in Black History is. That's all you have to do. Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Noble Drew Ali, Deuce Ali, just whoever, Frederick Douglass, whoever you think is the greatest historical figure or your favorite historical figure. That's all you have to do is let us know that. Once you do, you're automatically entered to win a KBLA Black History Month swag bag full of some really cool stuff. So download or open the KBLA 1580 app today for your chance to win. We will be announcing winners on the air live every day this month. Also, Where y'all at, KBLA? I have not, and this is no cap, I have not gotten one single order for my book, The Shrouded Lighthouse. I've been trying to tell you, man, The Shrouded Lighthouse is a fire book. All you got to do to see my social currency is go to Amazon.com and read the 30-plus five-star rated reviews. The book is crazy. When I tell you, it's bananas. The Shrouded Lighthouse: How to Discover the Silver Lining in Any Situation Shift. All you have to do is go to my website, theshroudedlighthouse.com. Theshroudedlighthouse.com. I also have other books. My 2019 release, The Holographic Relationship. Very powerful book. All week long that I've been on the air, we've been dropping jewels from each of these books, as well as my 2015 release, The Relationship Dismount: How to Stick the Landing When Exiting a Toxic Relationship. We going bananas. Tonight's topic is no different. Can I tell you, a lot of men suffer from this, but I want to know, do women suffer from this as well? I want to hear from you guys. This is a caller-friendly show, and we don't have a conversation without your participation. The number to dial is 1-800-920-1580. 1-800-920-1580. Tonight's topic: crumple still skin. No, not rumple still skin. Crumple still skin. A deeper look at simping and pandering. Men do it all the time. Simp for women's attention. Jumping through hoops just so they could be cool with a girl that doesn't give two shakes of a fat rat's butt about them. Simping, pandering, crumple still skin. Do you crumple under the pressure? Do you need attention? Are you seeking attention? We're going to talk about it. We're going to talk about it when we come forward. The Voice of Reason is on fire. We having a simp intervention tonight. I said we're having a simp intervention tonight. I need everybody to call in. The number to dial is 1-800-920-1580. 1-800-920-1580. Get to your phone lines. Were you a simp before? Are you a simp now? Do you pander for pussy? No cursing. You can't call in and curse. No cursing. All right, no cursing. We're having a simp intervention. Oh yeah, I wipe this place down when I get up in here. Yeah, they gonna catch me slipping. Hell nah. I got that Osium. Air sanitizer. It makes you cough and sneeze a little bit. Shit. Hey, I don't want to beg y'all to call. Jump the fuck in. All right? Look, I don't want to beg you to call. You know I need you to call. You guys make the fucking show. Y'all don't call, no, it ain't no show. And also, I'm tired of people coming Johnny Come Lately. I can't hear the callers. Listen, this is a behind the scenes. You want to hear it? Download the KBLA app. Push the play button once you do that. The app is free. Download the KBLA app. I need y'all to call. Call, call, call. There's the number. Damn. I guess I gotta ask you to hit the like button and the share too. Come on, don't do me. Don't do me. And besides, you're missing the playlist. The playlist is crazy. From the start, want to see, baby. Who's simping out there? Valentine's Day right around the corner. A lot of simps. It's simp season. Do you have to buy chocolates, dinner, flowers for something you about to all, that's something you already had? Oh Lord, simping. Hey, listen. Ladies, stop pimping your man. Huh? Don't use the punani to pimp him. Huh? To pimp his performance. It's a lot of simps out there. Where does simping come from? Why do men employ simping? Huh? Why does a man feel the need to have to simp? Huh? Why is he a master of the preferred performance that women demand of him? Do nice guys ever win in relationships? Do good guys ever win in relationships? Do women tend to attract bad guys? Do they tend to be attracted to bad guys? Why? The good guy is always in the friend zone. The good guy is always the one whose shoulder is wet from her tears after the bad guy drug her down the street of her life. You know, oh my God, you've always been there to listen and understand when I'm going through things. But he never really gets a shot with her. Why is that, ladies? I want to hear from the ladies. Please call 1-800-920-1580. Today's topic, crumple still skin. Not rumple still skin. You crumple because this woman you want. And I think women simp too. Do women simp? I need to hear from ladies. Have you ever simped for a guy? I need to know. Huh? What are some of the adverse side effects of being a pushover in relationships? Men, call in. What are some of the adverse side effects of a man being a pushover for a woman? What are the adverse side effects of a woman being a pushover for a man? Urban Dictionary defines a simp as someone who does way too much for a person they like. This behavior, known as simping, is carried out towards a variety of targets, including celebrities, politicians. Somebody said e-girls and e-boys. I guess, is e digital, or I don't know what an e-boy or an e-girl, I don't know what the term is. Sipping hard, according to the Urban Dictionary. When you're simping over that one person and can't stop, right, you begin to listen to sad music. Wow, I've never listened to sad music. This is, let me just say this. Because a lot of people get it twisted. A lot of people don't understand the subtleties and the nuance. Is there a difference between being sympathetic, empathetic, and simping? We live in a manosphere world where a lot of men don't want to feel, because they feel like many women are users, relationship mercenaries. It's really awkward to have this kind of movement going when a man's wallet has always been the mercenary in the relationship. I'm just saying, if a man is a provider, if a man's wallet is leading the way, does that mean he is a covert controller and possibly simp? Because when that money leaves and she leaves along with the money, a lot of men go begging. Huh? A lot of men turn into simps. Baby, baby, please don't leave me. Baby, baby, please. I'm going to get back on my feet. I promise you, I'm going to get back on my feet. What's the difference between simping and having empathy for another person? When it comes to maintaining peace in your relationship, are you a part of the go-along to get-along gang? Tonight's topic, man. Simping. Woof. Let me just say this. I've never been a simp. And you know why? You may not like what I'm about to say. America is toxic. Our culture is toxic. So if the culture is toxic, I always use this metaphor. If you're swimming in a 12-foot deep pool, and the liquid in the pool is urine, you're going to get some in your mouth. Meaning, if society is that pool, you're going to get some of its toxicity in your spirit. What does that have to do with simping? Well, this society has made relationships transactional, right? It's about give and take. It's about what you bring into the table. It's not about who you are. It's not about the content of your character. It's not about the quality and the integrity and the moral compass that you bring. It's about, can you provide safety on a social level? Can you provide consistency and certainty on a social level? But on a psychological level, can you protect me, listen very carefully, from my wounds? From the stuff I need to work on. And it's unfortunate. That's toxic, right? In a lot of relationships, right, people consider their mate a good mate if they align with the coping mechanism that they developed to protect an internal wound. Protecting an internal wound keeps it alive. Wow, I said a mouthful. And I don't know, man. Let me just say this. And I got so many things that I want to say. Where there is a lack of self-knowledge, the chances are very high that you will also find a developing pushover within the heart of that person. I'm going to do whatever. I'm going to be a people pleaser. I'm going to please every aspect of this woman. I'm going to do whatever she say. I'm going to jump through hoops. Are you a hoop jumper? Have you been a hoop jumper? I need to know. The phone lines are open, 1-800-920-1580. Talk to me now. Get to your phone lines right now. I want to hear from ladies. Ladies, have you done things that you're ashamed of, trying to keep a man? Have you done things that have maybe been defined as being a pushover in relationships? I'm really interested to hear the woman's perspective. We know there are massive male performers out there. And I've told people this before. men perform because that's the preferred language women listen to. What do you mean, Zoe? The preferred language that women listen to. Women listen more to your behavior. And I've told women that's how you set yourself up to be lied to via behavior. Behavior is a type of communication. And some would argue it's the most effective form of communication. So if a man is performing with his behavior, a woman will deem him as solid, while at the same time ignoring her intuition, which is giving her insight into his intention for why he's doing what she thinks she wants. It's a cold situation. Relationships are a cold situation. I'm not going to do anything you think I'm supposed to do unless it's in alignment with the truth of who I know myself to be. Now, if you don't have that knowledge of self, you're going to be looking for external acceptance. You're going to be looking for external approval. You're going to be looking for an external source of self-esteem. But all of those sources, if they're coming, or all of those things, if they're coming from an external place, are finite. The only place where there is infinite happiness, the only place where there is infinite acceptance, the only place where there is infinite self-esteem comes from within. It's all an inside job. So if you don't have it, you set yourself up to be a pushover. Chef Mike from Los Angeles, I need to hear your thoughts. Keep going. Keep going. So look. So chef, just hold on 1 second because I think they want to talk to you. Just hold on 1 second, all right? No, you know what's crazy, what he's saying? I know if he's a chef, his behavior, first off, Taco Tuesdays has gotten a lot of dudes' attention from women. You feed a woman. The performance of feeding a woman, in a lot of cases, will get you a long way. But again, feeding her. Are you pandering? Are you pandering by taking a woman to dinner? Now, I know back in the day, you had to do certain things. I got to pull the chair out, right? I got to pay for the meal. Back in the day, you had to do a few things, right? But here's my question. What are you really doing it for? I'm going to tell you right now. You go into a relationship looking for somebody to complete you. You go into a relationship looking for somebody to lift you up. Man, you're setting yourself up for disappointment. I've been saying it for over 10 years. Relationships are not designed, right, for that person to make you happy. They're just not. Society has their rules. Society's rules say you're supposed to act like this, you're supposed to behave this way, you're supposed to treat a person this way. Okay, it's a half truth. The real truth is relationships are designed to show you what's wrong with you. And if you find yourself catering to a person too much, if you find yourself bending over backwards to a person too much, they don't acknowledge you. They don't respect you. They don't respect your boundaries. You're a pushover. And I'm going to say it again. Why? I'm going to ask the question. Why do you allow yourself to be walked over? Listen, man, you better go back. You better go back into your history and find out your relationship attachment style. What is the quality of your relationship with your mother and father? Do you have a quality relationship with either one of them or both of them? Do you have a toxic relationship with either one of them or both of them? All of these things are indicators and factors for why you allow yourself to be stepped on. Do you know how to establish healthy boundaries? Do you know how to stand up to your partner? Is there a way that is respectable, that gains respect from your partner? They give it to you in standing up to them the right way. Oh, God. Crumple still skin. Crumbling under the pressure. A deeper look at simping and pandering. Man, we do this a lot in relationships. I'm not going to pander to anybody. And I'm going to tell you this right now. I reveal aspects of myself when I feel like it. I'm never going to be pressured by anyone to reveal aspects of myself. I'm a book that you can't read in a year. I'm a book that you can't read in 3 years. I'm a book that you can't read in 10 years. And I'm constantly growing. And you're not going to force me to give you an answer that I'm still developing. We're live. VOR. KBLA 1580. I want to hear your thoughts when we come forward. Hey, where in the fuck are y'all? How many times I got to set it up? You liking it? Tavis is like, this boy crazy. Are you a simple Jedi Master or Sith? Look, yeah, I did it at the top. I'm going to do it again. Yes, sir. Where y'all at? What's up with the calls? Come on, man. How many times I got to set it up? How many times I got to set up the topic? Do you know in the last segment I talked for 16 minutes straight? I could talk the whole 2 hours. Fuck it. I ain't going to ask no more. That's the last time I'm going to ask.
Jack in the Box's new 15-piece nacho tiny tacos for just $3.50. Grab the tiny tacos you know and love now with nacho cheese flavor in every bite. Or get them bacon loaded with bacon, melted cheese, and ranch on top for $4.50. Order now on the Jack app or have them delivered.
At KBLA Talk 1580, we are Black History 24/7. But it ain't, simps are not just men. Simps are women too. Simps are women too. And a lot of times women don't want to acknowledge the fact that they be simping. But they do. I just want to say thank you guys for hitting the like button. We got almost as many likes as we got people viewing the show. So thank you guys. That's gonna give me a goddamn strike. Fuck. Everybody that's listening on YouTube, this is the behind the scenes. You can't hear the callers. The volume on the callers won't be loud. You gotta download the KBLA 1580 app if you wanna hear the callers. All right, you gotta download the KBLA app if you want to hear the callers. It's really that simple. You want to hear the callers? Download the KBLA app. All right, download the KBLA 1580 app. You want to hear the callers? Download the KBLA 1580 app. If you want to hear the callers, download the KBLA 1580 app. If you want to hear the callers, download the KBLA 1580 app. If you want to hear the callers, download the KBLA 1580 app. James Blanks, what up? No Fucks Given, what up? Haru Ali, what up? Third Eye, what up? Lovelace, what up? Dollar Will, what up? OG Bobby T215, what up? Eddie C. Floyd, what up, fam? Yo, you know I'ma sanitize. You can believe that shit. Live in 30 seconds. What up? IBC Lee, Dollar Will, Eugene Pleasant. What up? Here we go. What I mean to say, who out here simping? Hey, listen, man, I'm not saying a man can't serenade his woman. But if you out here performing so you can score a touchdown. And sometimes scoring the touchdown, the sexual touchdown, isn't what you're really after. Sometimes the touchdown might be their approval of you. You know what? I knew you was a good man. I told you earlier in the week, maybe last week, you are not a human doing. You are a human being. And if somebody mess with you or rock with you because of what you do and not because of who you are, that person is not really in your corner. I'm telling you that the doing is necessary for a relationship. But in the analogy of icing and cake, doing is icing. Being is the cake. Do you understand? There's a whole bunch of clowns out there doing for attention. Doing for approval. Let me hit you with some of Eckhart Tolle. Listen, you remember Eckhart Tolle, right? The Power of Now. Oprah Winfrey introduced him. He's a weird German guy with a strange little voice. But he has some powerful quotes here. A genuine relationship is one that is not dominated by the ego with its image-making and self-seeking. Come on, man. An empty person spends a lot of R&D, right? Research and development, time, energy, and effort on building up their image. And they're seeking self to be recognized from the outside. I put all this time and energy manicuring an image to be accepted by the external people so that they can claim that as the truth of me. No, the truth is you, the person, the broken person behind the mask, the manicured mask that you present with your best foot forward. Listen, when you walk into a relationship, hop in there with both feet. Don't step in there with your best foot forward, because that's a performance and that's a half-truth. Here's another powerful quote from Eckhart Tolle. In a genuine relationship, there is an outward flow of open, alert attention to another person in which there is no wanting whatsoever. When somebody is in a relationship, when they come to me wanting stuff, boy, that is the biggest turnoff ever. Want me. Don't want what I do. Because what I do is going to flow from me organically. Listen, do you know the difference between demanding and commanding? Black people been demanding stuff from this poisonous society for centuries. And when you have to demand something, that means you don't have it. But when Denzel Washington walks into a room, he commands our attention. He ain't got to ask for it. That's Denzel Washington. Malcolm X walked in a room. He commanded our attention. That's because he was rooted in knowledge of self. Many of these relationships are rooted in a fake image that our ego created. And that's why we're pushovers. That's why when your wallet is empty, what you gonna do when she leaves? Huh? That's why you simp. I ain't never had to simp. I know people are gonna get mad at me for saying this. But in this toxic society, we have elevated amongst our own people colorism. Michael Jackson cut off 90% of his nose to look Anglo-Saxon and European. Lil' Kim did the same. Huh? Jada Pinkett messed up her beautiful face. Because we all want to look like their standard. But when you go to the Cosmopolitan magazine, they have a European standard of beauty and they marginalize and denigrate the African natural beauty. What does that got to do with Zoe? Zoe is light skin, green eyes, 6'2". I never had to pander for it because self-hate in my people made me seem attractive. Oh, I want my baby to have green eyes. I ain't never had to pander. Do you pander because you have self-hate? You don't like your skin? You think you too dark? Huh? You listening to Charlie Murphy, darknesses. You too dark to feel good about yourself. You better throw off the devil's definition of who you are. Richie from Pasadena, rest in peace to your uncle Richie. What's up, good brother?
You gotta hold those people accountable. know what I mean? So, stay true to yourself and understand that, you know, the subconscious does not influence you, it will fall to you back. So, when you watch TV that's controlled by, you know, the power that they're going to have subliminal images that attach your subconscious about things that you're going to question them. But you know that the original man was dark skinned, the original woman was dark skinned, and that gives us a natural and intellectual superiority over everybody. So,
hey man, I appreciate you for taking the time to call me. Rod from Nashville. Bring the volunteer state in the building. Talk to me about it. Go deeper. This is cold. Ooh, keep going. Keep going. Let me just say this, man. And you just got to keep it real. It's a superficial transactional society. So the reality of it is, if you not 100% on top of your game, where they can see benefits from being with you, they not going to give you the time of day. It's really that simple. They not going to give you the time of day. You got to be 100% on your game. You feel me? And when I say on your game, I mean mentally, financially, psychologically, all your stuff got to be together. Because if they think for one moment that you not together on all levels, now mind you, this is coming from somebody. Listen to me. These demands that they got, these demands are created by broken people. Love doesn't operate in the space of demanding, in the search for security. Love, authenticity doesn't operate that way. There is no wanting or yearning for somebody to come along and make it all make sense. So these people are putting demands on you to be everything that more than likely they are not. So how you broken demanding that I be complete? And as soon as I see that, I'd be like, if you don't find the largest boulder on your block and take your shoe and sock off and kick it, kick that rock as hard as you get out of here. You're not even on the level to be demanding nothing from me. Wow. Hey, Rod, thank you for the call, man. That was heavy. Thank you so much, brother. You brought Nashville, Tennessee into the building. Thank you. Let me say this again. I am not here to coddle or date your unhealed wounds. I'm not here to date your trauma. Your trauma is reflected back to me so that I may see my own trauma. Now, once our trauma has been revealed to us through the mirror of relationships, you know what's supposed to happen? We're supposed to take responsibility for self-work. When we come forward, more on the Simtastic topic with the VOR. KBLA 1580. Yo, I'm dropping too many jewels. Yes, hypergamy exists.
Need any water or anything?
Yes, please. Hey, Lovelace, I need to hear from you. Lovelace, you damn near part of the show. Heru Ali, you damn near part of the show. I need to hear from y'all. Y'all help the show be fire. Don't just get in trance listening to me. I need to hear y'all talk. Sir Jinx, holla at me, bro. Roguish Son, call the line. Cam Freed, call the line. I need to hear from y'all. Don't just let me fucking post the... I said I wasn't going to say it again. All right, my bad.
Number, right? Okay, I should shut the fuck up.
Fuck it then. I'll do it without you. Supremacy 45. Thank you, brother, for hitting that super chat. Hey, the super chat is live, y'all. Y'all can hit it. What up, Brandon Gotch? What up, Travis Booker Jr.? What up, what up, what up? What up, Zylon? What up? Oh, can I tell y'all? All of these shows are on the KBLA app under podcasts. Every show I've recorded in the past 2 weeks, they've created a podcast. So now you can hear every one of these shows. So people saying they can't hear the callers and all of that, go to KBLA, go to the app, click podcast, and all the Voice of Reason shows are there. It's me, Robert James. What up? Yay, baby. Hey, you know what would be a great record to play right now? That's Joe, right? Who is this? Dave Hollister, right? Hey, when we come back, we gotta play things your man won't do. We gotta play Let Me Cater to You. Men ain't the only one who simp. Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to The Voice of Reason. Live on KBLA Talk 1580. We talking about simping. People pleasing. When I see a people pleaser, I know I'm dealing with a vacuous, empty vessel. It's not my job to fill your cup. It's your job to recognize that this feeling of emptiness is an illusion. And how do you recognize that? Through self-inquiry. But self-inquiry is a type of question. How do you discover the question? Well, your partner, your significant other is your question. And your significant other can never be your answer. Your significant other is a question that only you know the answer to, because that answer emanates from within. And once you start to inquire deeply and you start to recognize that their trauma and their triggers are dating your trauma and your triggers, once you start to recognize that, you begin to discover how to ask yourself questions using your partner as the ultimate question, and then you start to develop these answers that have always been within you. And once you start recontextualizing who you are and who you thought you were, you begin to grow up spiritually. Now, when you grow up spiritually, you show up spiritually. Oh, Lord. I know y'all not ready for this kind of talk. You'd rather just have a people pleaser, somebody that's made out of Play-Doh that you can form to the shape of your unhealed wounds. Well, I'm not here to coddle that. I'm about my truth, and I dole out and divvy my truth in portions that I feel comfortable in giving you. I'm not giving it to you because you're demanding. You know how many people done broke up with other people because they ain't got what they demanded? I'm not here to fill your cup with my answers. You fill your own cup with your answers. When we come forward, we going to Dallas, Texas. We going to Beverly Hills. We going to, I don't see where Heru Ali is coming from, but we going all over the nation. Oh, Heru Ali's from Michigan. We're going all over the nation. When we come forward, we talking about simping on The Voice of Reason. Where is sensitivity? Ralph Tresvant. Yes. Where is... Babyface, soon as I get home from work. Ladies and gentlemen, if you want to hear the callers, download the app. If you want to hear the callers, download the app. Rod from Nashville, man, thank you for calling, brother. I appreciate you. download the KBLA 1580 app, click podcasts, and you'll hear all of my shows. They're uploading all of my shows. Zoe Williams back in the building. I'm talking to Simpaholics. You better get off that narcotic, boy. You understand? A woman will never respect you if you're too pliable. If you're silly putty. Ladies, call in if you disagree. Some of y'all love a little resistance in a man, don't you? Let me get to Heru Ali. You got 30 seconds, Heru. Talk to us. Yes. Lord, Lord. Hey, brother, you brought Michigan in the building. We appreciate the call. Thank you so much. Listen, when we come forward, I'm going to Beverly Hills. I'm going to Texas. I want to hear from ladies as well. The Voice of Reason is live on KBLA. Come on, y'all, let's simp together. Valentine, right down the street. Tell me what kind of man treat his woman so cold. Hey! When you're worth more than gold. Girl, you're like a diamond. I love the way you shine. Hey! The Voice of Reason is live right now. And I ain't got no sense. This man is singing to another man's woman, talking about giving her gifts. What in the entire hell is wrong with us? This is why our relationships are poison. I'm gonna do all the stuff he didn't do, all the hoops he didn't jump through. I'm gonna jump through them lickety split. Baby, I wanna do all of things your men won't do. I'll do them for you. Get your corny self out of here. Knock it off. You know what that's called? This allows women to go out and do something that they call monkey branching. You know how monkeys swing from one branch to another? There's relationship monkey branching. I'm going to hold on to this branch because I get sandwiches and my cell phone is paid and I got my oil changed and he good for certain things. But when what I really want come through, I'm going to let go of this branch and swing into, I do this for you. No! You's a monkey brancher and you was only holding on because it's what a bird in the hand beats two in the bush. You see what kind of games are being played out here? I am so tired of empty people trying to cultivate real love. Then they run around and bastardize the word love based on what somebody did. Don't you know? You need to understand why people do what they do. Where is the why? This is why you don't have no boundaries, because you ain't never known that you were full to begin with. Somebody told you you were ugly. Somebody told you you were broke. So what you start doing? Tap dancing and performing for attention. That's why social media is so big. Let me hit you with a little Krishnamurti. Jiddu Krishnamurti, my favorite philosopher. Relationship to oneself, to others, to the world is the book that this quote is from. A man who loves obviously has no enmity, and to all things, and to all these things, he is indifferent. Sympathy, forgiveness, the relationship of possessiveness, jealousy, and fear. All these things are not love. They are all of the mind, are they not? The mind can only corrupt love. It cannot give birth to love. It cannot give birth to beauty. You can write a poem about love, but that's not love. So many people say, I just want to be held. I want somebody to acknowledge me, but have never gained the tools of self-acknowledgement, self-approval. Nobody, listen, once you approve of you, all of you, good, bad, indifferent, dark, ugly, unfinished, once you say, I'm good with me regardless, because walking this life, this one life you got, you're going to encounter all types of relationships. And those relationships are not designed to make you feel whole from the outside in. Those relationships are designed to make you recognize that you are whole from the inside out. They are mirrors. This world is a fun house. You're in a fun house full of mirrors. That's what the relationship is. And sometimes these mirrors are distorted. Sometimes you have a distorted view of yourself. I'm here to teach tonight. Y'all want to learn about relationships? Or do you want to run around and constantly pander and just be on some pleasing people? Let me please you because I don't want you to leave me. Let me please so you won't leave. If you don't get your begging tail out of here, where there is a beggar, there is a capitulator. I cannot capitulate in relationship, and I refuse to. Do you? Do you refuse to capitulate? I'm just asking. How many of you guys are relationship capitulators? Huh? I'm just asking. How many of you are out there? Krishnamurti says, love. Listen now. Love. A man who loves, obviously, has no enmity. And to all these things, he is indifferent. Sympathy, forgiveness, the relationship of possession, jealousy, and fear. He is indifferent to all of these. So many scared, unforgiven, lack of sympathy type people out here. They're all users. And if I'm lying, call in and tell me different. Huh? When we come forward, the phone line shall crack once again. The voice of reason is online and he's on fire right now. We'll be back. KBLA 1580. Caller, Roderick, Charlotte, Jerry, Beverly Hills. What's his name? Rothlaston, Dallas, Texas. What's Rogerson? Got it. Ruth, call in. Share your thoughts. D. Hamilton, I appreciate the Cash App. How's the show going? Yeah? Right. Sixty seconds. Circulate manifest. Circulated manifest. Thank you for the Cash App. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Circulated manifest. Thank you for the Cash App. Ladies be simping too. So let me tell you why I played this record. If a woman is doing this and she's empty, she thinks she's empty, I should say. She hasn't dealt with her internal issues and she's doing all of this to try to keep a man. I'm telling you, catering to somebody before you cater to yourself is a recipe for disaster. You understand? The energy that is wrapped in protecting your wounds and not dealing with them is repulsive. It's pushing people away while pulling people in, right? It pulls them in so you can be triggered to see what you need to work on, and then they can only stay for so long and you push them away. That's a type of simping when you're catering without catering to self. Oh, I know that. I know that hurts. Roderick from Charlotte, you're in the building. Talk. Hey, man, I appreciate the call. Thank you so much. Remember, it was the big brother, Steve Harvey, who said women run this whole thing. If a woman say, wear suits, men will wear suits. If women say, wear zoot suits, men will go out and buy zoot suits. If women say, wear little booty shorts, men will be out here in some booty shorts, some Daisy Dukes. Some Daisy Dukes and some Stacey Adams with some footsie socks with the little ball on the end. Women dominate, right? That's because those are a tribe of panderers. Real men are secure with themselves, secure with who they are. That's why it's never been a problem for me. Is it a problem for you? You can call in. No judgment zone. Call in. Let's work through it. Ladies do it too. Call in. Let's work through it. Jerry from Beverly Hills, you're on the line. Let's talk. Okay, go ahead. I want you to talk more, Jerry. Go ahead. Can you sing the song? What was the song? What was the song you wrote for? Let's hear it. Hey, Jerry, let me just say, man, you got courage, man. Thank you so much for calling in from Beverly Hills. We appreciate it. Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't know, you know now. The Voice of Reason is the show to call into. This is the show. Listen, we got Rothlisson from Dallas, Texas on the line. Dallas, get in here, man, and tell me, man, what you think about tonight's topic. Yeah, I don't know. It's all right. Mm-hmm. Hey, Roth, let's, no cursing. No. Well, the way it's spelled, Rothlishin, okay, roguish. And you was roguish right now with the curse words, bruh. No cursing. Well, let's talk about that a little bit. Let's probe into that. There are, and a lot of people don't understand this. If we're going to use Bell's curve, right? Bell's curve says the average, the regular folk, are in the middle. And the average folk, the regular folk, make up the majority of the folks. On the far end of the bell, you have really great people. On one end of the bell, you have really great people. The far end of the other side of the bell, you have really bad people. So I say that to say there are a lot of amazing, great women. And those great women will elicit a particular type of response from a great man. Right? But everybody, and vice versa, but everybody in the middle are trying to use each other to feel better. Are trying to use each other to escape self-work. Now, what comes out of this is the manosphere. What comes out of this are hybrid versions of feminism, right? And the reality of this whole thing is transactionalism, using each other, relationship mercenaries, relationship brokers. Listen, you can't demand anything from me if all your currency is in your face and your booty. Your booty and beauty can't be the only currency you have. Do you understand what I'm saying? But if you are a nurturer, if you are a healer, yes, you hear these like these fringe feminist groups talking about, I can't be your therapist. Why not? If the world is against me, how come you can't come console and heal me? Why not? Why can't you be a guru? You know what guru means? Dispeller of darkness, a guide. Why can't you be a sign that points me in a direction that, you know, of course I got to do the work, but that's a good woman, right? No. This society said it ain't her. But listen to me now. I'm going to throw it to you, Roguish. Listen to me. Society says that ain't her job. That ain't her business. Now you go. No question. No question. Brother, you brought great insight to the show. I appreciate the call. Thank you. Absolutely. So let me add on. Because I mentioned knowledge of self, right? If you have knowledge of self, you have a center by which to interface ideologically and behaviorally, psychologically as well, to your woman or to your man. Did you know in ancient Egypt, we don't live in ancient Egypt no more, knowledge of self, right? White folk all over the world trying to steal your culture. There's an Arab curator by the name of Zahi Hawass. He's an Arab. He's not Egyptian, but he'll claim Egyptian as a nationality. But as an ethnic group, the Arabs are now saying they're Egyptian. And this is why they keep coming out with all these different remakes of the ancient pharaohs, and they all look Arab. If you know history, once Egypt fell, it fell to Rome. Mark Anthony and them, Caesar and them fell, right? And once it fell, and once the Romans left and all of that, once that all got out the way, the Arabs went in there and took over and lived there. Where are you going, Zoe? That knowledge, that body of knowledge is an African body of knowledge. It is not an Arab body of knowledge. Every pharaoh, every king who sat on the throne could not sit on the throne unless he came from a specific matrilineal line. Do you know that? Going all the way back to Usir, Asar, Osiris, Aset, Isis. Osiris and Isis. That's the anglicized Greek pronunciation of Usir or Asar and Aset. When you look at Aset, her hieroglyph is a throne. When you look at the throne that every pharaoh sat on, it was Aset. The throne is the woman. All African belief systems revere, respect, and appreciate the woman. That ain't simping. That's putting her in her right position. You go to South Africa, you go to West Africa, Ile Ife, Ifa, they talk about the divine Iami, the divine mothers. When you talk about Oshun, everybody want to wear that yellow skirt and that multicolored skirt now. Beyonce talking about Oshun, you want to talk about Oshun? The sweetness of life. African culture always venerated the woman because they understood the divinity of women. Now, does that mean men aren't divine? No. Men and women are collectively divine, but they held them in high esteem. In this society, who has no knowledge of self, they don't know that a set means the throne. They don't know it. In this society, you think being cute and having a fatty means you get half, means you get to demand stuff. We live in a hypergamous reality or society. Hypergamy, the action of marrying or forming a sexual relationship with a person of a superior sociological or educational background. Well, how do you establish that relationship if all you got is a cute face and a slim waist? And the reverse of that is, brother, how do you establish a meaningful relationship with a woman when all your meaning is in your wallet? Without your wallet, you nothing. You don't have no guidance. You don't have no presence. You don't have no moral compass. You don't have an internal center or axis that allows you to not listen. People always say, oh, you got to compromise to have a successful relationship. Yes, you do. You compromise certain things. But one thing you never compromise is yourself. Huh? If you in the business of self-compromise, you are by definition, in a colloquial sense, a simp, a panderer. I'm not compromising air bit of me. The thing that makes me me will not be on the table for discussion. You either ride with me or you ride off into the sunset. You either rock with me or you kick rocks. That's what it is. And then we can go from there. I'm not saying I'm inflexible. Do you understand what I'm saying? I'm not saying I won't listen. I'm not saying I won't consider. What I'm saying is, when the core of me is on the table and you saying, change this, do this, I would be happier. Why don't you tell me that? I'm not doing none of it if the core of me is on the table. When we come forward, more about pandering and simping on the Crumple Stillskin Show. Voice of Reason is live. Yo, can you pull up a silencer? The sound of a silencer? Because every time I drop a jewel, I need to hear the silencer. Pew, pew, pew.
Your guest, Michael Collier?
Oh, bring him in.
Okay, I got you.
How you feel, King? Good to see you. Yeah. This is nice.
So, Michael, we talking about simping.
I don't know if they...
Pandering. Pandering to women.
Oh.
Compromising. Conforming.
Hmm.
Doing whatever they say, jumping through hoops.
And why would we do that?
Yes, that's what we're talking about.
Oh, okay.
Yes. A deeper look at simping, pandering to women, pandering to people, being an overly people pleaser. right? In relationships. Hmm. There's no winning in that.
I don't think there is.
Yes, there's no winning in that. And I'm going to set it up for you when we come back.
Okay, because I can't hear you in here.
Oh, let me get you.
So turn up just a little bit.
You tell me which one is.
No, I think it's the one closest to me, maybe.
No, that one's mine.
It's that one.
This one?
Yeah.
Is that good?
Yeah, turn down a little.
Turn down?
Yeah.
There you go. Perfect.
Cool.
Michael Collier in the building.
Hey, man.
Hey, and we live on my YouTube right now.
Oh, hey, what up, family? I brought the chicken.
Michael Collier.
Live on your YouTube.
Oh, it's on the cracking.
Oh, man, calls are still coming in to wish me happy birthday.
Yes, brother. We're going to wish you happy birthday live on air.
Oh, I will take a water.
Can we get Mike a water? Oh, yeah, I done wiped all this down, Mike.
Huh?
I done wiped all this down.
Oh, that's okay. I was just trying to make sure.
No, go ahead. You good. You can double wipe. I done triple sprayed. Mike.
No, we good.
I ain't playing.
So sweet. Thank you. Yeah, this looks nice. Station.
Yeah. 1 minute.
You're on until 9.
What'd you say?
You're on until 9.
Yeah.
Cool.
It's almost over.
Cool.
I've been here acting a fool.
Acting a fool where I was too.
Uh-oh.
You'll be very proud of me.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, very nice. Very good. Sniping off the real good start. She said she would get makeup all on my. Yeah, okay.
Brother Mike.
Yes, sir.
Y'all wish Michael Collier a happy birthday, man.
Woo, woo, woo.
Woo, woo, woo.
Happy birthday. Tell it to the chicken.
Here we go. Where that Ralph Tresvant? Ralph Tresvant. Hey, Terry Lewis and Jimmy Jam, they know how to make a record, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. But overly sensitive, I don't know. Today's topic, man, we talking about simping, people pleasing.
People please.
You can't people please enough to fill that hole in your spirit. Mm-hmm. If you gonna try to please somebody, right?
Okay.
In order to keep them there, that is an absolute losing battle. I tell people this all the time. That's not how you keep people, right? Mm-hmm. People going to do what they want to do. They're going to come. They're going to go. They're going to stay. They're going to participate. You trying to make them stay is a fatal flaw. I like what Paulo Coelho says. He says, if you live to please others, everyone will love you except you.
That's cold.
I'm not simping for nothing.
No.
Ladies and gentlemen, guess who's in the building? Just walked in right now. It's his birthday.
Who that is?
Michael Collier.
Oh, yeah. Woo, woo,
actor,
woo,
woo. Comedian, producer. Yeah.
And he brought the chicken.
Michael. Come on, man. Talk to me,
no
man.
No simping, man.
Talk to me about
simping
this, man.
Simping is the opposite of pimping.
Uh-oh.
No simping.
Talk to me, man.
No simping. Well, you know, you're supposed to really make sure that you're happy. You can't be happy by making other people happy. You get happy by being happy first. Mm-hmm. And when you're happy, you'll lift people up around you, but you won't be jumping through fiery hoops to make sure they're happy, because that's like you're feeding a desperate need that they have, and you really want to just walk away from the people who are desperate.
Mm.
You know, let them deal with their needs somewhere else, because you ain't going to never fill the hole that they have.
Mm.
They're going to need that filter. The more you please them, the more stuff they're going to ask for. I think people have to respect each other's wishes and desires and needs.
Yes.
And if it's a relationship,
mm-hmm.
you're supposed to be in the business of lifting each other up anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to out-love each other, out-help each other, but not out-stress each other.
Talk to me. Talk to see. Look, Michael done came in here and set the tone. That's what we talking about. That's what we talking about. And I've always said, and I say it differently. Many mm-hmm. I say it different ways. Mm-hmm. I can only be in a relationship context. I can only be a question. I can't be your answer.
Mm-hmm.
Your answer is always internal. And it's mm-hmm. and it might be an answer you've been running from.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And relationship serving as a mirror, I come in as a mirror of the answer you have,
mm-hmm.
which manifests as a question. Now, mm-hmm. that question might be irritating.
Okay.
But just like that indicator in your car that says check oil, check engine.
Mm-hmm.
That relationship mm-hmm. is also mm-hmm. saying check self.
Yeah.
Check self. And a lot of people think that external people are their answer. Talk to me about your idea on that.
Well, you know that happiness is an inside job.
Talk to
you
me.
Know, it's an inside job. You know, I've been in a relationship and I walk away and they say, well, you've taken my joy. I can't take your joy. Mm. I didn't give you that.
Mm.
God gave you that. So you have to love you. You have to, it's the inside. I mean, if you handle all the issues inside you, then there are no issues outside of you.
Mm-hmm.
So people like, man, are they all needy and stuff? They're going through something. Now, you got to decide whether you want to go through that something with them or whether you want to be in a relationship that is mutually nurturing.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying? Or if you just want to do your thing and let them do their thing. You know, those are your three options. Ooh. You know, I'm not going to ever be the one who is just trying to please you. I mean, I want to please you because you're worthy of being pleased.
Ooh.
You know? And, I mean, it's something I need to give Ooh. You, but not like the neediness, you know, keep giving, giving, giving. Mm-mm.
Does worthiness have to ask for it?
Hmm. Well, you would hope it wouldn't. If they're worthy, then you are going to voluntarily give it up.
Look at that.
You know, if they're worthy, they're not going to have to ask. So, yeah, no.
Yeah, no, it doesn't, right? And what's interesting about your answer, it leads me to the clinician side of it.
Okay.
When they talk about disclosing in relationship,
mm.
they have a term called disclosure reciprocity. And what it means is they've studied couples who share intimate details about themselves. And what they understand about the human condition is mm-hmm. if I share something deep with you,
mm-hmm.
it compels the listener to want to reciprocate.
Or at least you hope it will.
But that's what they call disclosure
because that's
reciprocity.
The only way it works, yeah.
Right. They're saying mm-hmm. if you're authentic and there's a bond there
mm-hmm.
and you share,
mm-hmm.
there tends to be a reciprocity.
So you're not going to hold back from each
exactly.
other. You're both going to give each other.
You're going to give.
Right.
Now, giving isn't, real giving doesn't come through force.
No.
There's a natural flow to reciprocity, you see?
Mm.
And I think it's very difficult for people to reach that level of giving because they're holding on so tight to what limits them internally. Your thoughts?
Mm. I think, you know, a lot of that's going to come from the baggage they brought from the previous relationship.
Ooh.
You know, what was going on before they met this person, or was anything going on before they met that person? That's going to be what they use to make their decisions as to how they feel about this person or how they can relate to a person. You know, I think that everything's about relationships and communications.
Mm-hmm.
It's how you're related to a person and how you talk to that person or communicate with that person that will determine how high you go, you know, how close you get, how much you'll let down your guards and trust another person enough to really release some things that you've been holding on to for a long time.
Because
there's some stuff you can't tell everybody.
Mm.
I'm sorry, some stuff you ain't gonna never tell everybody. There's a few items you ain't gonna tell nobody, no matter what happened, you know? But depending on how you feel that other person, the give and take from another person will determine how much you're going to open up and let that flow, you know?
You just said one of the key buzzwords for relationship, trust.
Mm.
And I've always said that trust is fear-based. When you don't trust you, you seek and demand trust from your partner when you don't trust you. And to me, trusting yourself is connected to accepting yourself. Your thoughts.
I think it's the opposite. I think
say more.
I think distrust is fear-based.
Come on.
That's what I think. I think because if you don't trust the other person, you're distrusting that person, which also is parts of you. Because people always think that the person they're dealing with is going to do to them what they would do to them.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So I would sneak around on you. So you probably don't sneak around on me. Ooh. You know, if I can get some on the side, I'll probably get some of you. No, you probably want to get some on the side too. So that's that unnecessary fear that makes you go deep into that arena where you're not invited into yet.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, two things can be right. Here's a quote from Jay Krishnamurti.
Okay.
Is there security? Is there permanency, which man is seeking all the time? As you notice for yourself, your body changes. The cells of your body change so often. As you see for yourself in your relationship with your wife, with your children, with your neighbor, with your state, with your community, is there anything permanent? You would like to make it permanent, but there is no permanency. Isn't trust rooted in permanency?
I don't know. I think the permanency will depend on how much trust there is, how much it actually grows.
Listen, when we come forward, Lord have mercy. Michael Collier in here hitting him out the park. It's his birthday. The Voice of Reason is live on KBLA. When we come forward, more from the birthday brother, Michael Collier.
All right.
Woo! I like setting you up. I know you. I know what you do.
That's great. And you know all this right up my alley right now.
I know.
I'm doing my my transition from the relationship I've been in for 9 years.
You're on camera.
Oh, it's okay.
Okay.
The thing that I'm doing too is like, I've already let her know that I'm letting people know it's in my act now.
Yeah.
You know, I'm on stage every night telling people.
Yeah.
I am newly single, brother. You know what I'm saying? You know, after 9 years, as of June 6th, man, I'm newly, and I tell artists, I say, you know, I'm newly single. That don't have anything to do with anything, but I thought I'd just put it out there.
But you're born on a 9.
Oh, yeah. February 9.
And 9 is the number of completion. Beginnings and endings. So you was in a 9-year relationship. It ended in the 9th year.
Wow.
Your birthday's today, the 9th.
Wow.
Now, if you're paying attention to numerology, you see it pop up oftentimes in sports.
Mm-hmm.
I tell people this all the time. Streaks end on a 9. Remember the Patriots went 18-0 and lost in the Super Bowl? Wow. 1-8 is 9.
Right.
I knew they were going to lose to the Giants.
Wow.
Pete Carroll had the USC Trojans on a 27-game home streak, and Stanford came in and beat them. They was ranked number one in the nation. 27. 2-7 is 9. Endings and beginnings.
Wow.
You had a 9-year relationship. That 9th year, that's it. I'm done.
Wow. Yeah.
Look at that.
That was it. That was all. I couldn't take no more. I can't take no more.
I can't do it no more. Mm-hmm. I love Brother Michael.
Yeah.
Hey, man, you know, as soon as we get up out of here, I'm going to the cigar lounge.
I have a dinner at 10, so I got time for one cigar.
Oh, wait, I forgot.
It's 9 o'clock, right?
Yeah. I forgot. It's birthday time.
And cigar lounge is like 4 blocks away or something?
It really right down the block.
It's right down the street.
Yeah.
Right. La Brea right past Salsa.
Okay. You know.
right. And I'm going the opposite way for dinner because I'm going to Tao.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Nice, brother. Nice.
Yeah, I like that. I'm going to end up going Dutch. My friend.
Let me do this real quick for you. Can you hear me? Is Tavis still here? Can you find out? Because I want to introduce Michael to Tavis.
You know he's been knowing me for years.
Well, you know he's about to re-know you.
About to re-know me. Yeah, he's supposed to be brand new.
And then I talked to Marcus. He said he's going to get to you. I said, make sure you get to him.
I just was hoping that he didn't trip out because I sent 10, what's the name?
No. Not at all. He, no.
I sent 10 promos. I was sitting in my studio, brother, and they said, do 2. I just kept on doing them, variating the words, doing nothing.
There you go.
I'll give you something to pick from.
Yeah. Live and 30, here we go.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, the voice of reason is going to stay turned up. I'm sorry, man. I'm a harbinger of truth. I was brought here to tell you the truth unapologetically.
That's the only way you can set them free.
That's right. You're listening to the voice of reason live on KBLA Talk 1580. I'm sitting in the studio with my good friend, my brother,
yes,
actor, comedian, producer, Michael Collier, and we're talking about simping.
Yes, sir.
Listen, there is absolutely no way to make the unwilling happy. That person who is unwilling to listen to themselves, that person who is unwilling to let go of the baggage you spoke of earlier, to acknowledge that broken inner child, there's no way to please that person. And if you are trying to heal that inner person, that broken person, by trying to please others, you are setting yourself up for more disappointment. Your thoughts?
Man, you said it all. You can't do that. You know, everything I can say, you have to have a relationship with people that is nurturing and healing for you too. You know, if you're giving to them, okay, give to them, but your giving of them should also bring it back. You should be, but not just, you know, we talk about karma, which is circular.
Right.
But the whole thing really is to be not just circular, but singular. So you, like a cylinder, you go upward, you spiral, not just go in a circle, not just what goes around, come by. But as you come around, you should come around with more knowledge, more energy, more connectedness, more power. So you really should be spiraling upward. To do that, you have to have honesty with the person you're trying to connect with. You got to be very clear on what it is you want from each other and what you're willing to give to each other.
Right.
Or you're going to always be in a situation where the one person takes a position of power and they know you need them or feel you need them, and then you keep laying out the table more and more. Okay, you gave me that, now I need this. That wasn't enough, now I need this. You know, and it just keeps coming.
Now, some people say honesty is what you tell them. But honesty is about being true to yourself, too.
Yes.
Now, you see, a lot of people can't be honest because they're not true to themselves. So they can't be honest in what they say because they're not honest with themselves.
Give me an example.
For instance, you can act like you're the mask you wear, but that real you behind the mask is the true you.
Okay.
And until you embrace and accept the true you, you're going to be out here the PR person for the mask you wear. And the problem with that mask, it needs maintenance. You got to keep updating it. You got to keep fixing it and adjusting it. Listen, when we come forward more with my brother Michael Collier, boy, it is on fire here tonight.
This is great.
Yeah, we'll be back. Well, when we come forward, we'll, KBLA's out. I messed up. I got turked up too. I got too turked up.
Nice.
No, this is good.
So you was doing 7 tonight?
Yeah.
Nice.
I'm doing it tomorrow. I'm doing it Friday. I've been here for almost 2 weeks.
Today you sent me the thing saying that you hit 5 to 7. I was like,
No. That's my sports show.
Oh, okay.
But I was just sending you the details on
so
how
I can get in. Yeah. Okay, all right. Yeah. And I was driving, I was like, oh, I missed it, but it would have been worth it, bro.
Man, yeah. You in here killing right now. Man, I love setting you up, brother. You know that.
Yeah, beautiful setups, too. I can work them.
Yeah.
Come on with it.
And we broadcast it live on my YouTube channel.
Mm-hmm.
So that's beautiful. People are interacting. Everybody in here saying happy birthday to you.
Oh, hey, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
February 9th.
Come on with it, somebody.
On the Aquarius side of the game.
Yes, sir.
It's I don't know time. What you know, but I know what I know.
This our time.
Yes.
This our time. You know, they talked about the dawning of the day.
Yes.
The dawning of the age of Aquarius, but now we're here. That's yes. What this age is
100%
right
here.
Now. So, yeah, we kill. I mean, I'm in the best spot I've ever been in my life, brother.
Good.
Getting out that thing, moving on in my life, new house, new everything.
Come on, man.
Very excited. Very
Come
excited.
On, brother. Live it.
Hey! How you been, King?
Just gonna give you a hug, man.
It's good to see you, bro.
Hey, don't take it off, nigga. Don't take that off. Don't take that off, nigga. Cleveland's the board of hell.
I'm trying to match it up. I see that.
Don't show the shoes.
You
don't do that.
I do what I can.
Cleveland's the board of health, man.
It's good to see you. How you been?
You know, Sunday chitlin', man. I'm doing all right.
Yeah.
It's good to see you, man.
It's good to see you, man. You're working with another king, man. That dude was the best.
No, you won, though.
My brother right there. He got this going off on the air, by the way.
I used to see Michael on Venice. That's how I fall back.
Yes.
I'm a Michael fan from Venice days.
Yes.
I'm shooting it this summer, brother.
Yeah, you shooting it?
Man, let me show you the stage.
Yeah.
We built a stage that looks like a king's crown, brother.
How much time we got? A minute.
He said 30 seconds.
I can do it in 15.
Here. Don't worry, we good.
Your number's still the same, Michael?
Oh, yeah. Okay. I've changed wives, houses, and dogs, but I still got to say, I'll build the stage look like a king's crown that I stand in the middle of with the speakers for the ambient sound. I use a vision board instead of a wall.
When you shooting it?
I don't know. Yeah. We working on a producer. Now I just talked to brother CAA. He said, man, call me. I'm getting a producer. Sure. And it's going to be people surround me for as far as I can see. I'm going to collect my money like I usually do, but we're taking it to the homeless.
I'll talk to you about it. I'll talk to you.
Awesome.
All right.
Well.
Wow.
We at the final segment. It's a short segment.
Mm.
Let me do this real quick, man. Where are you performing next?
Greenville, South Carolina. Four shows this weekend, two Friday, two Saturday. You have four opportunities to miss me if you in town.
My brother, you still out there on the road putting it in.
Every weekend, brother, and 5 days a week. I'm here at 7 a.m. in Los Angeles doing the Michael Kaya Morning Show. That's on YouTube.
Talk to us a little bit about that. Where can they find it, and what is the show about?
Well, if you just go to YouTube, put in the Michael Kaya Morning Show, I would say if Johnny Carson was black and was on the internet, that would be the Michael Kaya Morning Show. It's talk variety, mostly comedy written. A comedian starts at the top of every show, and halfway through each show we pray. I want to create a place where people can come and laugh and pray every day, because I just think people are more messed up with stress and fear than they are this actual virus. So I want them to have an oasis where they can come and laugh and just start their day with big energy.
And I did your show before and loved it, man.
Thank you, brother.
Woo, woo, woo.
Woo, woo, woo. The chicken is there.
Hey, man, Michael Collier is one of my good friends. He's a solid brother. Hey, man, and let's talk to Tavis about getting you over here, bro.
Hey, man, let's see if y'all might have a room. They might have another room. Y'all still got a big place over here.
You like
it's
it, huh?
It's an awful big spot. Oh, yeah. Tavis been rolling for a long time, bro.
Hey, if you could inspire somebody right now to start giving to themselves instead of being a people pleaser, what would your best advice be right now?
Remember to absolutely love yourself, because God created you. And he didn't create you with some junk. He didn't say, well, let me take this chicken and a bottle of water and make some niggas. And he said, no, I'm going to create you with designer jeans, G-E-N-E-S. You're already the best of the best. So all you got to do is love yourself. You ain't got to go begging God forgiveness. He ain't ever mad at you. Just love you. Once you get to love yourself, then you can love the world. So be kinder to you. Don't be so hard on yourself. You're already exactly where you're supposed to be, because everything is in divine order.
Man, if that ain't a word...
I don't know what is, man. Love begins inside.
Yes, sir. It's an inside job, brother.
And the more you love yourself, the more that love is reflected back to you through the relationships that you encounter.
Exactly. When somebody come at you mean spirit, that's what's going on in them, brother. Ooh. When they come at you with love, that's what's going on in them. They can, you can only do what you know. You know, if you knew more, you do more. If you felt a certain way, you would do it that way. It's what you're feeling. It's in you, man. You can't change that.
I want to thank everybody for tuning in. Thank you, man. This has been the Voice of Reason on KBLA Talk 1580. Zoe Williams here, sitting in for Dr. Jashana Johnson, who is in Ghana with her whole family, living her entire best life.
Nice.
We so appreciate you guys tuning in, getting the phone lines cracking every day that I've been here. Thank you so much to Tavis Smiley for giving me an opportunity. And again, if you want to get my book, The Shrouded Lighthouse, all you have to do is go to theshroudedlighthouse.com. We appreciate everybody for tuning in. I'll be back tomorrow, 7 to 9. When we come forward, news, the VOR was live.
I love that, coming forward instead of coming back.
Yes.
I love that.
Yeah.
When we come forward.
When we come forward. Great show. Thank you.